Hi everyone, this is Kevin here, coming at you with Samsung Galaxy A51 tips and tricks. So let's get started. Now the first tip I want to show you is how to get a battery percentage in the corner at the top of your device. So this is really simple. Pull down the shade, go to settings, go to search, type in battery, and then you'll see down at the bottom here an option that says show battery percentage. Now for a lot of the tips that I'm going to be showing you in this video, you could navigate through the various menus and the settings to find these different options, but I recommend just going in the search and searching it up because it will save a lot of time. So anyway, you can see here show battery percentage, tap on that, and then you'll see an option right here that says show battery percentage. So turn that on and you'll see up in the corner, it now says the percentage. So no matter where you are in the operating system, you'll always see that now in the corner and you'll know how much battery life your device has left. The next feature I want to show you is called side key. So go to the settings again and then search side key and then you'll see it right there. It's under advanced features. So tap on that and then go to side key. So with side key, you have a couple of different options. First thing is you need to turn on double press so that if you double press on the power button, you can activate one of these various options. So you can have it so that if you double press on the power button, it will quickly launch the camera. So we'll turn the display off, double tapped, and now it pulled up the camera here. So very cool. You can also have it open Bixby by double pressing on the power button. I'm not going to do that in this demonstration here because I personally don't use Bixby, but if you do use Bixby, then you can do that. And this is probably my favorite option here. You can actually open up an app of your choice by double pressing on the power button. So I have it set right now to open up Instagram, but you can go over to the settings here and then you can pick whichever application on your device you want to have start by double tapping on the power button. So I'm going to keep it at Instagram. And again, you know, it's set there on Instagram. So whether you're within the operating system itself, you can double tap on that button and it will pull up Instagram or whatever other app of your choice. Or if you turn off the display and double tap on the power button, you will have to either put in your PIN code or have it use your face to unlock the phone or use the in-screen fingerprint sensor. But essentially, it will take you right over to that app that you have programmed for side key. So by default, if you press and hold on the power button, it will turn on Bixby. However, if you just wanted to pull up the power off menu, you can switch it to that. And then if you hold down the power button, it will just pull up the standard power off, restart, or emergency mode menu. So I'm gonna leave it at that actually, because like I said, I don't use Bixby, so I don't need to hold down the power button to turn on Bixby. But that's a really awesome feature there. I'm really happy that you can pick an app of your choice to activate by double tapping on the power button. Now with Android 10, they've further expanded gestures. Now by default, you do get the standard Android navigation buttons at the bottom. And I know that many people do like that, but if you do want to get the gestures, pull down the shade, go to settings, go to the search, type in navigation, and then go to that option there. And then you'll see navigation bar down below, tap on that. And you have a bunch of different options for the navigation bar. So you can keep the standard navigation buttons if you want to, and you can even switch it so that you can have the back button on the opposite side and the recent applications button on the opposite side as well. So maybe you prefer that instead. I'm going to go with the default because I am right-handed and I commonly use the back button more than the recent apps button. So that makes sense for me. But if you do want to switch over to gestures, you can tap on full screen gestures. And then from there, you'll notice that you no longer have the full navigation bar at the bottom. You now just have like this little line at the bottom. And if you want that to go away, you can turn off gesture hints. Now I don't mind having it, so I'm gonna turn gesture hints back on. And you even have an option here to show the button to hide the keyboard. So if there's a certain situation where you want your keyboard to disappear, you'll then have a button here so that you can make it disappear. But essentially now with the full screen gestures, it's very similar to how the iPhone 11 works, for example, where you just swipe up, it takes you to the home screen, and it doesn't matter what app you're in. So maybe you're in the dialer and you want to head back to the home screen, just swipe up again. Now, if you do want to access your recent apps, you swipe up partially and then you'll see your various recent apps up here. So very similar to iOS. And then if you do want to go back, you just swipe from the side. So it makes a lot of sense and it does work really well. And then if you want to, you can switch back to the standard navigation bar and it will update at the bottom. Next up, I'm going to show you how to change the clock style on the lock screen. So right now on the lock screen, this is the way it looks. But if you don't like that, you can easily change it here with the Galaxy A51. So go to the settings, go to search, type in clock, and then you'll see clock style. And then you actually have a bunch of different lock screen settings. So you're welcome to go through all of these and kind of configure them to the way you want to. But I feel like one of the highlights certainly is the clock style. So tap on clock style, and then you have options to change it for the always on display or the lock screen. I'm going to go to lock screen. And then you have a choice of a bunch of different clock styles. They're all very interesting here, all very different. I'm going to switch over to this one, and then you can even change the color if you want to. So you can have an adaptive color to auto adapt the color to the background, or if you want to switch to a certain color, you can pick from any of these pre-selected colors or gradients, or you can even go here and you get even more colors to choose from. So very awesome that you do get the ability to customize the lock screen. Now, if you start to notice that your Galaxy A51 is getting a little bit slow, there is something that you can do to make it faster. So pull down the shade again, go to settings, go to device care, and you'll see device care right there. And then from here, it will check your device, and then it will find different things that it can delete. So it can delete unnecessary files, close background apps, and run checks. And you can do this as often as you want to, by the way. And then just tap on optimize now, and it will begin optimizing your phone to speed it up. So that's something that Samsung has been doing for a while with their other devices as well, but it's something that does work really well and certainly will give you better performance. And then when you're done, tap on done, and then it will take care of it. And then you're all good to go. Now this next feature is a feature that doesn't really come in handy for me necessarily, but I think can help some people watching this video, and that is dual messaging. So for certain apps, you can only have one profile signed in at a time, and you might have multiple accounts. So Snapchat is one that I could think of, but you might have other applications where this comes in handy as well. So type in dual messenger, and then there it is under advanced features, so dual messenger. And then essentially with dual messenger for different apps that are compatible and supported, you can actually have two different copies of that same app on your device. So Facebook is one of them, and it'll show you whatever app is available based on the apps that you already have downloaded on your phone. It would be nice to see one giant list of every app that is compatible with this, but unfortunately it doesn't work that way. But if you want to use whatever available apps are on here with dual messenger, just turn it on. And then you can see here that you can install a second copy of that app. So again, for my situation, none of the apps that I've been using with the Galaxy A51 support this besides Facebook, but maybe it'll be different for you. And then hopefully over time, as this feature becomes more and more mainstream, more and more app developers will make their app compatible with it. Now, one of my favorite things about Android is that you do get an app drawer for all the various apps that you don't use that often. It's also a great place to see all the different apps that you do have installed on your phone. However, if there's a certain app that you want to hide, maybe you don't want to have it on your app drawer here, then you can actually hide it with the Samsung Galaxy A51. So hold down onto the display and then go to home screen settings. And then from home screen settings, and by the way, there's a bunch of different settings here, so you can go through here and see which settings interest you, but go to hide apps. And then from here, you can choose whichever app you want to hide. So maybe you want to hide Duo, for example. We'll tap on that, and then it's up here in your hidden apps. So even if you do hide apps, you can always bring them back, and then tap on done. And then now I'm going to go over to my app drawer, and you can see that Duo is nowhere to be found. So a very awesome feature there from Samsung. Now another cool feature is that if you want to double tap on the display, it will activate the display, but you do have the ability to toggle that in the settings. So pull down the shade, go to settings, go to search, type in lift to wake, you'll see it right there. And then you have the option to turn on or off lift to wake. There's also double tap to wake, like I just showed you. There's also smart stay so that it'll keep the screen on while you're looking at it. And then other options too, like smart alert, easy mute, palm swipe to capture, and swipe to call or send messages. Now with the Samsung Galaxy A51, the device does feature a very large display, and it is sometimes difficult to reach certain parts of that display. Now, if you turn on one-handed mode, the one-handed usability with the phone will be a lot easier. So pull down the shade, go to settings, go to search, type in one-handed, and you'll see right there, one-handed mode. Then from there, you do have the ability to turn it on. So we'll turn that on. You can also tap on it to see more features. So essentially, you have the choice here of whether you want to activate one-handed mode with a gesture or if you want to double tap on the home button. Now I prefer to activate this with the home button, so I'm going to switch it over to home button. And then by double tapping on that home button, you can see one-handed mode is now activated. Now what's really cool is that I do have the ability to resize this one-handed mode within these two constraints. And then you can also move it to the left or right sides. So since I'm right-handed, moving to the right side makes the most sense for me. And then I can continue to use the phone as I normally would. And it's basically like a little mini phone here. So very awesome. And then if you ever want to go to the one-handed mode settings, just tap on this gear in the corner and it'll take you right over to there. And then to get rid of one-handed mode, all you have to do is tap outside of the screen and then it takes it to full screen. Now Samsung does give you quite a few animations here with the operating system. So if you do want to reduce the animations, you can actually do that pretty easily. So go to the gear, go to the search, type in reduce, and then you'll see reduce animations. So tap on that, go down here, and then turn on reduce animations. And you can see there's now a lot less animations when going around and using the device. Now, if you want to take it a step further, you can actually remove the animations, and that's under accessibility. So type in remove, if I can type myself, remove, and then you'll see right there, remove animations. Turn that on, and now the animations are completely removed. So it makes the device way faster, and you can easily navigate all around the device with no problems at all, much faster. Next, I'm going to show you how to screenshot. So if you want to take a screenshot, just tap on the volume down and power button at the same time, and then you're good to go. Then you have some different editing and sharing options as well for that screenshot. So very awesome. Now you probably noticed that on the right side here, there is this little indentation and that pulls up the edge screen. That's a great way to check out your favorite apps and to have quick access to them from anywhere in the operating system. Now, if you want to remove this, pull down the shade, go to settings, go to search, type in edge, and then you'll see edge screen right there. And then right there at the bottom. So you can turn that off completely if you want to turn off the edge panels. So if you are looking to turn that off, then you can do that from here. Now with the Samsung Galaxy A51, you do get an always on display if you want to. So to control that, go to the settings, type in always, and then go to always on display. It's right there. You can tap to show more details. And then basically with the always on display, you can turn it on. You can set it to tap the screen to show it for 10 seconds. You can set it to show always or show continuously. And you can also set it to certain times to show. In addition to that, you have other options here as well for the clock style. You can show music information if you want through face widgets. And then you can also set it so that you can rotate the screen. But let's check out how the always on display looks like now that I have it set to show always. So you can see that the always on display has now been activated. So very cool and very convenient there. And finally, the last feature I want to show you is pop-up screen. So this is really awesome. So I'll pull up the YouTube app as an example of this. And essentially all you need to do is go to the multitasking button and then hold down on the app itself. And you have a variety of different options here. So the first one is open in a split view window. I'm sure you're already very familiar with split view, because that's a feature that many Android devices have had for a long time. But there's also, of course, pop-up view. So I'm gonna tap on that, and it essentially gives you like a mini app on top of your regular home screen. And you can resize this if you want, which is great. You can also change the transparency. So if you still wanna see what's behind the app, you have the ability to do that. And then if you want to completely shrink it, tap on this button to the right of the transparency button. And it'll basically give you like a little mini icon there that you can access no matter where you are or whatever app you're using. And then you can just tap on it again to pull up that mini app. And then there's a button to completely close out the app. Or if you want to use this button right here, you can bring the app to its regular full size. So I hope you enjoyed these tips and tricks about the Samsung Galaxy A51. These are some really awesome hidden features that I think many of you are probably not even aware of. But if you know of other tips and tricks that I did forget about in this video, then let me know in the comment section below. I'll probably make a part two if necessary, because I know that Samsung has packed in so many extra features with the Galaxy A51, which is awesome. But make sure to check out my other videos on the channel, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.